Hey guys, this is Jose from the Denver Public Library ideaLABs, and welcome to another episode of Learn, Make, Share. Today, we're going to continue learning how to make music, but also learn more about working with digital audio and MIDI in Soundtrap.
Last time, we learned that Soundtrap is a browser-based digital audio workstation, or DAW, where you can record, create, and edit music and audio. We became familiar with Soundtrap's layout and many of its tools, including loops, the beatmaker, and how to play with instruments and tracks. If you haven't already, check out a previous Soundtrap video, which I've linked in the description. In this video, we're going to dive deeper and learn a little bit about what MIDI is and how it allows us to work with digital audio. We're going to take a look at the piano roll and become familiar with manipulating things such as note pitch, length, and velocity. Additionally, we'll learn how to fix timing issues with quantization. We will explore Soundtrap's effects libraries and learn how to use them in our project. And finally, I'll show you how to export your music as a shareable file, which you can then share with friends, family, or other musicians. Everybody works at their own pace, so please pause the video when you need and rewind if something isn't clear. We will continue to use the internet browser version of Soundtrap, but you can use any device with an internet connection and browser. If you've got a PC, Mac, or Chromebook, you can just head to soundtrap.com and click on Join Now to create an account for free. If you're using a phone or tablet, there's a free Soundtrap app in both the Android and Apple stores you can install. Click on the Get Started when you open the app to create a new account. Once you're logged in, click Enter Studio on the web version or Create New Project in the app version to make a new song. Before we start working on our music, let's talk briefly about what MIDI is and how it relates to working in Soundtrap.
Meanwhile, I'll be demonstrating some of the tools and skills covered in this lesson.
Firstly, MIDI stands for Musical Instrument Digital Interface. So in other words, MIDI allows electronic instruments and other digital musical tools to communicate with each other. MIDI itself does not make a sound, it is just a series of messages like note on and note off, which are then interpreted by a MIDI instrument to produce sound. A MIDI instrument can be a piece of hardware like a synthesizer or part of a software environment, like Soundtrap. All of the instruments we are able to play are MIDI instruments, and when we record them, we're not recording sound, but rather sound is interpreted and produced based on the information from our input, similar to how a word processor produces letters and symbols according to what we type on a keyboard. This is why we can use a MIDI controller, our computer's keyboard, or even a makeshift controller to play instruments in programs like Soundtrap. MIDI is also what gives us the ability to manually manipulate individual notes and fix things like volume or velocity, note pitch, note length, and timing, all without having to re-record every time we need to change something. In the piano roll, you'll be able to see the notes that you're playing on the keyboard or adding in with your mouse. Think of it as a music box. Wherever the scrubber is, it will play the notes as it scrolls over them. The advantage of being able to work in the piano roll is that you don't have to be a master piano player to create the melodies or harmonies you want. All you need is a little bit of practice. So let's get started. In order for us to work in the piano roll, we'll need to start with a new track and select an instrument. I really like working with synthesizers, so I'm going to pick one that doesn't have too much reverb. Just as a refresher, reverb refers to how long a sound is heard after it is produced. Now that I've selected my instrument, I can open up the piano roll by clicking on the instrument icon located on the left side of the instruments column. Since I'm working with a synthesizer, I should see piano keys and the knobs for reverb, pan, and volume. Above those knobs, you can find tabs that read instruments and piano roll. So we'll go ahead and click on the piano roll tab. You should see what looks like a rotated piano keyboard on the left and a grid to the right of that. If you can recall from the previous video, our recordings are measured by time, with the scrubber or playhead moving left to right. The same concept applies when working in the piano roll. You can even see the playhead move across the grid just like in the workspace. Notice now how the rows are color coordinated, with some instances of double white lines. That's because they match up with the piano keys on the left, so the white lines are the white keys and the black lines are the black keys. This means each line has a different pitch, with higher notes going up and lower notes going down. I'll show you what I mean by recording a note and changing it in the piano roll. The default tool in the roll is called the Move tool, which looks like our regular cursor. This is an incredibly useful tool as it allows us to move notes up and down to change pitch, and left and right to change its timing. We'll look more at the Move tool and others in the following sections. Now, we'll learn how to use the other tools available within the piano roll. We can find them in the top right corner. In addition to the Move tool, we have the Draw tool, the Velocity tool, and the Erase tool. Let's start with the Draw tool. Just as the name suggests, we can use this tool to draw new notes. Simply click in the grid to add a new note. I'm going to try and draw all of the Y keys from C to C, which is the C major scale. You don't need to know anything about music theory or scales for my demo. This is just one way to show you how things work. I want to walk up and down the scale, so that means that I'll need to pay attention to where I draw my notes. Notice how I drew my notes in the white lines, moving up and over, and then I came back down and over. I did it this way because I want to hear each note play one right after the other. Keep in mind that Discover shows you what notes or sounds will be played at that exact moment. If I just drew all the notes on top of each other, then they're all going to play at the same time, which will sound interesting, but that's not what I'm going for. Notice how I accidentally drew notes on the black keys? There are a couple ways that I can fix this. We can use the Move tool to move the notes to the right pitch and spot, which would probably be the easiest way to fix my scale. But what if I really messed up and have a lot of wrong notes? In this case, it would be easier to erase a lot of those notes and then redraw them. That's where the Erase tool comes in handy. You can click on all the wrong notes and they'll be deleted. Remember that you also have the Undo tool at the very top of the workstation, or you can use the keyboard shortcut, which is Ctrl-Z. Just a quick note, I've included a link in the description to a list of Soundtrap's keyboard shortcuts, which I found to be extremely helpful. So, why is the piano roll so special? Well, it lets you go in and edit your MIDI instrument recordings without having to re-record every time you make a mistake, which can save you a lot of time and hassle. Being able to work in the piano roll also means that you can still make music with just a mouse. You don't need a MIDI controller and you don't even need to have a computer keyboard. You can just draw your own music. It will take time and practice to compose this way, but it is possible. Now, let's go back to using the Move tool. Besides being able to move your notes around, this tool also enables you to change the length of your notes. Soundtrap automatically snaps to the grid, which makes it easier to place the notes where you want and easier to adjust your note length. If you want, the Snap to Grid function can be disengaged by clicking on the magnet icon in the top right of your workspace. If you click on the cog icon next to it, you can adjust the way that your grid looks, or change the ruler from beats to time. I'm not going to adjust anything for this demo, but the controls are there if you want to experiment with different time signatures. Going back to my scale, I can go in and make each note longer or shorter with the Move tool. When I hover over the edge of a note, the cursor will change in appearance to two arrows with lines in between, indicating that you can click and drag. I can make my note longer or shorter, and I can do so from either end of my note. If you want to change multiple note lengths at the same time, you can. Select all the notes that you want to adjust, then on any one of them, click and drag on the right edge. Now that I've got all my notes the right length, I want to make sure that they're in the right places. If I only have to move a couple notes, then I can use the Move tool. But if I want to adjust multiple notes, then I can use the Quantize function. To quantize notes in a DAW means to automatically move them to a certain subdivision of the beat. Basically, it will fix notes that are not in time and shift them to being on the beat. To do so, select the notes that you want to fix, then right-click and go down to Quantize. This should open up another menu with different fractions. I typically want to shift notes to the nearest quarter note beat, 1, 2, 3, 4, or to the nearest eighth note beat, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. But as you can see, you can select different subdivisions of the beat to fit your need and style. So, I'm going to quantize my notes to the nearest quarter note beat. The last thing I want to do in the piano roll is to adjust how loud each note is, which I can do with the Velocity tool. It is important to note that there is a difference between the volume of a track and the velocity of a single note. In MIDI, velocity is a measure of how hard or soft a note is played, which in turn affects the volume of that note. If I want my whole track to be louder, I can adjust my volume on the instrument setting to the left. However, if I want to make a single note louder, I will need to adjust its velocity. To use the Velocity tool, click on the V button in the top right corner. Note that the cursor will not change in appearance, but now there looks to be a little white line inside my notes on the roll. I can change the note's velocity by clicking on it and dragging my mouse up or down. A box will appear as you're dragging your mouse. The letter and the number pair indicate the pitch of your note. So for example, if we see E3, it means my note is the E note in the third octave. If you don't know what an octave is, that's totally fine. It may be easier to think of it as the third E key from the left on the piano keyboard. The number to the right of our note indicator is the velocity of the note. The velocity is shown as a number between 0 and 127, with 0 being virtually silent and 127 being the hardest and therefore loudest our note can be played. Just like some of the other tools in the piano roll, you can edit individual notes or you can batch them together and adjust multiple note velocities at the same time. It's really up to you as to what will work best. In my example, I can play back my scale and listen for any adjustments I may need to make. Right now, my notes have very different velocities, so I'm going to go in and change my notes one at a time to make them sound uniform. Listen to the difference before and after I edit my note velocities. Being able to adjust and balance note velocities is in itself a very useful skill, but it will be especially helpful when we begin writing chords. Take this C chord I've drawn for example. This C chord has three notes, C, E, and G, which I want to play at the same time. Playing these notes together is what makes it a C chord, as opposed to just playing the single C note. At this point, all my notes have different velocities, and this is how it sounds. Now, I will go in and balance the velocities. Can you hear the difference? It may be easier to hear with earbuds or headphones if you have them. Now, we will shift gears and I can show you how to use the effects available in Soundtrap. Soundtrap gives us the ability to further customize our sounds with effects. Most instruments will automatically have some effects activated, so we can change those effects or add new ones. To start, I'm going to create a new track while also muting the track with my scale. The instrument I'm going to use is the default lead synthesizer, Flutterwave. After creating my new track, I want to click on the Show Instrument icon. Once the instrument is open, look for the Effects button on the right, just above the keyboard. This will open up a smaller effects window where we have another place to adjust things like reverb and volume. Beneath that, we see what look like cards with different names, colors, and knobs. Each card is a different effect being used on the synthesizer. Notice now that each effect has an on-off button and a delete button in the top corners. These are here to help you manage your effects and are helpful when we're testing out what these effects do. We can stack multiple effects, so that on-off button will come in handy when we're testing. I'm going to play some notes while also adjusting my effects. I can add more by clicking on the Add Effect field, which opens up the menu of all the different kinds of effects that you can choose from. Many of the effects have a play button beneath so you can hear exactly what they will do to your sound, so go ahead and test as many as you want. One of my favorite effects is the auto pan, so I'm going to go ahead and add it to my instrument by clicking on it. My effect should appear next to the other cards. Here, we can adjust how strong each effect will be by adjusting the knobs. I find that it's helpful to play a note or chord while playing with the controls so that I can hear the difference in real time. Keep in mind that you have the option to switch them on and off or delete them completely. Effects can be applied to other instruments as well. Effects, along with the audio controls we learned about in the last video, and the piano roll all give us multiple levels of control for our project. There are countless combinations of instruments and effects, so play around and find a combination that speaks to you. The last topic I'd like to cover today, and one of the most important, is how to share your project with the world. After finishing your project, make sure to hit that save button at the top. This will also begin the mixing process, which happens after you save and will only take a moment. Once Soundtrap finishes mixing your project, you can export it as a playable, shareable file. Click on the File tab in the top left to open the menu, then go down to Export. This will open another submenu where you can select what format you'd like your project to be saved as. MP3s are smaller files with lower bit rates and will export faster, but at the cost of some of the audio information and overall audio quality. WAV files will be bigger with higher bit rates, which means they will take up more space but will be uncompressed, lossless files, and ultimately be the best quality audio recordings. It's up to you and how you plan on sharing your recordings, but typically MP3 gets the job done and is easier to share via email, text, messenger, etc. If you want to know more about file types and audio compression, you can check out some of the resources I've linked in the description. Thanks for making with me today, and for being interested in learning more about working with audio and Soundtrap. I hope that you have a better understanding of MIDI, and I encourage you to practice editing with the piano roll tools we've covered today. If you want to learn more about Soundtrap, check out some of the resources I've linked in the description, including information about how to join our live discussion about Soundtrap. If you want to show off what you've made, tag us on social media with hashtag ideaLABMakes.